Now we move on to the next topic and very important topic, and that too for the general practitioners, fever clinic requirement by Dr. M. Arunachalam. I welcome Dr. Arunachalam to deliver the lecture.
Thank you. Arun Vijay also the vendor. Arun Vijay.
I thank Professor Dr. Venkatesai, especially you called me to talk on the cotton, but well known to all, and now everyday changing coffee. First,
அருணாச்சலம் சார், வால்யூம் சரியா இல்ல. Can you use headphones? I'll first mute everybody, then unmute you, sir. Give me a second, please.
Arun,
lot of volume is coming out. Give me one second. Okay, sir. Arunachalam sir, go ahead. Thank you.
Yes. First, it is like just now I have seen a WhatsApp message like lockdown one was nothing you do, you can't do this, you can't do that, and you will be in prison, you will be locked down. Now 5-0 we have reached, and now everything you can do, it's up to you now. And we can't do anything. That is what the international body and government's guidelines. So our fever clinic guidelines also changed a lot. This is our WhatsApp message where the doctors had so many doubts, like how whether to open the hospital, whether to be in the clinic, whether to see the patient and everything. If we become positive, where do they provide treatment for us? At GGH or at private sector? No answer. This was a question I posed to our Honorary Secretary IMA Tamil Nadu State Board. He replied the same. For most of the questions, if one can patiently go through all the guidelines posted by IMA and government releases, you will get the answer. Let them spend some time to read. This is the message in every WhatsApp IMA group we had. And I think at the end of 3-0, lockdown 3-0, 16th May, 18th, we started the lockdown 4-0. We had a meeting in the morning along with the Commissioner of Corporation in Ribbon Buildings, where the government came down from every restriction. They wanted every doctor, every hospital to open and support them. They wanted so that all morbid patients should not reach the government hospital for fever to contaminate themselves in the government hospital. So, after forced to close down of hospital and quarantine for a contact, we are now asked to start our practice and watch for symptoms even for testing. Means even test you don't need to go for. In the previous one, when even in the month of, I think, 4th of May, I had a contact in my hospital and all my staffs and myself have to go for blood test, and it cost 4,000 rupees outside. Even private hospital nurses, they denied in government setup. So it was 32,000 rupees I have to spend for test, and test was negative. Now, even for positive case, they say, means positive means suspected case, they say only if symptoms are persisting, you have to go for testing. So such protocols have changed because we don't have 103,000 million what you call testing kits for testing all of us. Our safety is first before we do service. This is a compilation of various guidelines and tips for safe practice in this COVID era. For updates, our IMA Tamil Nadu website has been frequently changing. Various GOs from lockdown 10 to 40 now 50. The first GO was 176. We private doctors, we rarely we see all these GOs, but government doctors and government employees and government authorities, everyone go by the rule book. Whether they follow or not, when they catch you, they quote only the rule. So according to 176, it was lockdown for 15 days. Premises, I think our health center was locked more than a month. And then our doctors have been asked to go for home quarantine, even the staffs of the hospital for more than 28 days first, and then it become 14 days. Now it is even 7 days at the government one, and then 7 days in the home quarantine for even international travelers now. So the first 176, it ordered the contaminated surfaces are to be disinfected with 5% Lysol or 1% hypochlorite solution as given in the government order, Health and Family Welfare Department 54. It is April month. Then the disinfection of whole premises using mechanical sprays to be carried out in day one and to be repeated on third day. On fourth day, after thorough cleaning and washing of the hospital premises, followed by fumigation and standard solutions later by formaldehyde or then and allowed for respective contact timings. On the next day, the whole facility was to be washed and prepared for provision of health services. Means fifth day, you can open the service on in the April itself. Then came the GO 181. Here some relaxation was there, and 186, this is in the 16th of April, lockdown 3.0 end. Here, they really gave up. They wanted every doctor to open the clinic across Tamil Nadu. So morning we had a ribbon building meeting with the corporation officials, and evening we had a Zoom meeting attended by 247 IMA medical office bearers across Tamil Nadu with minister and the health secretary with all DMS, DPHS, everyone. And they all insisted for opening the hospitals and facilities to serve our patients, particularly the comorbid patients like the diabetic hypertension and the aged people and these elective surgeries. They wanted us to start immediately. And they were telling, we will not come to your hospital. We will not demand anything. But morning corporation official told that we need to have a pedaled, what you call, wash area, wash basin in your clinic, where we were insisting that it is not possible, but he did not give up. But in the evening, before the minister's meeting, our IMA office bearers were sitting in the office of the health secretary, where the health secretary was telling, you do whatever it is possible. You are doctors, you can treat, you are the one to judge and treat. So that is the way. So more than government guidelines or WHO guidelines, our IMA guideline stands gold for fever clinics. So entry of every clinic should have a wash area. This in shops, one clinic shop or one single room consultations, you can give after a thorough, you can ask your patients only by appointment to visit. And in appointments, you can ask them to wash their hands well at home itself. And on reaching, you can double wash your sterilization. And if you have wash basin, well and good. And then registration. Registration already, I think Dr. Venkatasai or our office bearers are good enough to keep general practitioner at the end, so that Sandeep has shown how it should be done in registration, and that stands gold. And patient waiting area with distancing chambers, exit testing if needed. Doctors room, doffing, donning, nursing room, these are all wanted of those things only in the lockdown one. Now, they don't demand. So norm for washing area, water, soap, preferably elbow tap for hand wash. All the patients who are coming to you, the fever clinic, should wash their hand, add feet with soap and water. Tissues to wipe, posters on hand wash techniques like this. This is a corporation issued one. I do not know how many of you have attended in the month of February end or March. March end, the corporation has conducted a meeting for all practitioners of Chennai Corporation Limits. I think whenever the such call comes, but they come only in the morning and we have to be there in their place in the evening itself. And I request all of you doctors to visit or to participate in corporation meets so that you are highlighted about how to conduct our clinic. This is my wash area where you have to, our watchman has the double wash, what you call sanitary agent or soap wash, and then you go and wash here. So mark the area stool with without arms, 3 to 4 feet distance for each patient. Here 2 meters is advised, not more than 10 patients in a well-ventilated room. But I would advise to ask your patients stand in your, to stay in their cars or stand in the platforms away from the clinic, and call them one by one by phone is important after registration. So this is how I conducted. It is more than a meter and armless chairs. And our staffs, after this, I think our IMA issued a face shield and everything. Now we wear face shield also. No attender if the patient is stable. This is what registration area guideline. 3-ply must be provided as soon as the patient enters the registration room without mask. Details of the patient to be collected as per the form number 1, which comes now. Physical distancing should be maintained 4 feet. It is 6 feet or 2 meters. 2 meters or what you call, it's almost 3 feet, 1 meter. So 6 feet is better. Patient to patient and patient to staff prefer via barricade. Means you stay away from the patient. Don't stand. Even when I treat, I ask the patients to sit and treat so that he will not breathe into my face level and I will not breathe into his one. And also I stay away from the patient, means not straight to the patient. And that is how I said, saved my hospital staffs and myself from COVID, even though 2 or 3 patients now are positive coming in. Sanitize the hand of each patient, vitals, temperature by thermoscanner, and pulse oximeter. Actually, from 2015, when I started my hospital, our member, Dr. Lalit Narayanan, who gave me the advice to have a pulse oximeter, and we have every nurse to have the pulse oximeter in their pocket. Every time they go in and get out, they have to check the patients in like IP also. The same thing, and now we are following. And pulse oximeter is the only one golden standard of detecting them. Now, when pulse oximeter says it is less than 90, nowadays with the experience, if aged people, we ask them to put the pulse oximeter in their hand to go away from the patient's area, remove the mask and breathe well and check. Sometimes it becomes without mask, it becomes 94, 96, 98. So we need not to threaten them. So ask them to wear the mask and ask them to go back home as soon as possible and then remove the mask at home. So sometimes mask also, mask the partial pressure on your fingertips. So less than 90, first timer, non-visor, clear indication is COVID into deep into the infection. Such patients, 4 or 5 patients, they have lost after visiting me, fourth day or third day, they were no more. The thing is, when we say they don't accept and they don't go to the hospital properly, they go into denial mode and the family sometimes is scared. And all these things I am seeing, and it is painful to see here that third day, second day, like government says within 40 hours they die. So when pulse oximeter detects less than 90, we are losing the patient in OP. That is my observation. And the other one is every instrument what we use, including our stethoscope and face shield, we have to wipe with sterilizing what you call chemicals. Do not hand over the form. Means first form, if you have filled, don't fill the, give the form to the patient. So already doffing and donning and everything we have already told, and separate cubicles, you know, for doctors and nurses. But I would advise every doctor, please come out of your consultation room, check the patients in your waiting area, if you have a waiting area, or come to your OP registration area, sit there. Don't allow your patient to come into waiting area itself. Ask them to stay outside in platforms. Nowadays, no shops are opening. I don't know how next week it is going to be, but with appointments and phone numbers is better. No patient should visit the hospital without appointment. And if on entry, if you have a nurse in one shot clinic also, let them have a pulse oximeter, check the pulse oxygen saturation first, and then allow them to enter. If less than 90, please you go outside and tell them that there is a clear cut indication for admission in government or private sector. So doffing, donning already is totally told about. So common hints about our dress codes. Daily, all their clothes must be soaked in. Already, we have our secretary even given more elaborate chemicals how to be used and washed. So, 0. Sodium hypochlorite solution. Actually, sodium hypochlorite is nothing but our bleaching powder, and it is dissolved in water. So, wipe the plastic apron with 0.5 sodium hypochlorite solution. Then, immediately be washed with soap and water. Dry in open terrace. Face shield to be dipped in soap water for 10 minutes and to be washed and dried. To be used next day, even 6th hourly, 8th hourly, you can do that if you have 2-3 face shield. N95 mask to be hand in the room to be used after 72 hours, or keep the mask in hot air oven at 65 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes, remove and can be used. So here, I am using a 3-ply mask because I am checking out the patient outside. I am able to breathe well. If you use your 3-ply mask daily and change it 8th hourly also, the smell does not harm your what you call N95 mask if you use it again. So 3-ply mask and then N95 and then with face face shield only. I check my patients, and that is one I recommend for our patients. But 55 plus, 60 plus doctors will face a very difficulty in breathing also. So first check your pulse, pulse oximeter, check your saturation level, and then go to check your patients if you are going to see beyond 60 plus. And I advise 60 plus doctors to stay home, even 55 plus if they have comorbidities. So preparation of 0.5 sodium hypochlorite solution. Now they are selling it in a costly way if it is not available. One scoop bleaching powder in 10 liters of water makes you 0.5% sodium hypochlorite. Keep in mind and you prepare your own sodium hypochlorite solution. So norms for doctor's chamber. As I advise, if it is outside, stand and treat. And in case you want to examine the patient, bring the patient alone inside your OP room and check here as early as possible and take the patient out immediately after clarifying his examination doubts. Non-touch technique is better. 4 feet distance from patients to doctor, stool without armchair for the patient, no attenders if patient is stable, one attender will be allowed if patient is sick with mask, stool should be cleaned as soon as patient gets up. Responsibilities of the doctors is he has to fill up the screening sheet, form 1A, make entry and preserve the form, notify the patient to the health authorities if warranted as per protocols. Here, now the government has relaxed everything. They don't ask you. They want you to treat like a dengue patient and they want you to protect. They want you to protect from your normal patients from a dengue positive patient if he's asymptomatic also. So this is the baseline of management now. In lockdown 5, everyone can be mingling. All positive patients, asymptomatic patients, carriers will be there in your clinic or on the public transport or everywhere. So we have to advise the patients to wear the mask always, to wash the hands always, and go about with self, what you call 6 feet distancing, 2 meter distancing is the best advice for patients and commonplace and in our hospital also. So manpower, they have asked these things, now they have given a pill. But for the sake of knowledge, total number of sheets at 2, 18 to 12 and 1.5. Doctors, one per sheet, paramedics, two per shift, two doctors, 8 to 12 hours, 1 to 5 nurses. This is what for hospital setups. So doctors, one per shift, paramedics, two per shift, housekeeping, two per shift, security, one per shift, office staff, two per shift, 3 days duty, 4 days rest, PPE kits. So this is how we now manage our patients outside the hospital, even inside the hospital also. Now, elective surgeries we conduct, like particularly patients with renal pathology, stones, calculus is more now, and we have operated too with the COVID test in hands. COVID test is a must for protecting our doctors in the operation theater. Even though when you prescribe a COVID test, they are asking only for ILI and SARI patients. So if necessary, you write as ILI. Because they don't test for contact now, and they don't test for elective surgery, even though the protocol is changing with lockdown 5.0. Records maintained. It is a patient register form and triage as per Government of Tamil Nadu, form 1B, epidemic case sheet, form 2B, lab referral form, notification register, disinfection protocols as per the guidelines. Every 4 hours, whole area you have to disinfect, seat and touchable areas as frequently as you needed. So I think around the weekly we use the motorized sterilization in and around our hospital patients area, inpatient area, and wherever patient has come into contact with. Awareness to public is very important. Media, I think our secretary is doing a good service for the Tamil Nadu, Tamil speaking people across globe now. Local announcement, control room, posters in front of all healthcare centers, clinic in the area. Clinics other than fever clinics should not see fever and respiratory illness. Here, fever, if it is without an ILI, that can be, that is also after 4 or 5 days, they become symptomatic and we refer them to COVID test and then they are positive. But here, first they have advised not to see. Now, the advice is you are the family physician, you are the doctor, you decide whom to see, whom not to see. But if a fever patient, don't allow them inside, go outside and check them and send them immediately as an emergency patient. then you make them wait and mingle with your patients and your staff in your waiting area. In all areas, non-touch distance will be followed. Distancing will be maintained. So here they go with three categories of patients. Category A, respiratory symptoms only, no comorbidities, no signs of respiratory distress. Category B, respiratory symptoms with comorbidities without any respiratory distress. Pulse rate, I mean, say, partial pressure of oxygen is 94%, which is respiratory distress here. And category 3 is respiratory symptoms with respiratory distress, no comorbidities, with or without comorbidities. Here, you can see SpO2 falling below 90. So this is a category C patients. So form 1 is nothing but the same one. Now we don't fill it up, but for sake, you have to do it. They are not going to demand, but it is better to have for a first few months of COVID fear. Now, history of fever, yes or no, and a cough means any respiratory symptom, ILI, and then contact tracing, and then if it is there, and then report control room, refer to designated hospital through dedicated ambulance. These are the things which we have to remember. Means if the patient is suspected to be COVID according to this chart, then 1, 2, 3 questions are yes, then you suspect COVID and then refer to immediately to COVID testing, COVID treating hospitals or tertiary care centers. If 1, 2 is yes, then acute respiratory syndrome, follow the existing protocol. If 3 is yes, then you have to immediately refer to the tertiary care center. And flow chart for outpatients, inpatients at health facilities, that is including government and private hospitals. Patient with fever, cough, and difficulty in breathing, give triple layer mask, maintain 2 meter distance between patients, screening and triage, use screening. Form 1, other respiratory illness, social distancing, appropriate management of illness following existing protocol. Suspect COVID if it is not this one, and then refer designated COVID center immediately. Use 108 and 1077 and advise your patients to contact these room numbers. This is international, state-wise, this numbers holds good. So history tells us that an informed, activated population is vital to protecting the public health in this era. This is the vital thing. And let darkness not fear. If below 50, please open your clinic from tomorrow. Save your patients not to be in touch with government sector or what you call COVID patients in fever clinics in government hospitals. Let us unload them. Let us protect our patients. This is the time we have to be with our patients. And protect yourself with all hand wash, each and every patient you hand wash, and wearing glove is not at all going to help you if you are not going to wash your hands, in my opinion, after every patient. And you sterilize your personal wearings every day, including your stethoscope, and then sanitize your waiting area daily with Lysol and hypochlorite solution, even bleaching powder, if it is outside parking, car parking area or outside area. And be safe yourself and help the society to come out. These are the time where we have to be various and we not to worry about. 55 plus doctors and with comorbidities, please stay at home for some more months until the symptom improves or the peak in infection has not reached. As per MGR University, that is to reach by July, August, 1.75 crore Tamilians going to be infected. That is what they expected one. Now we crossed 20,000. I think it is not far away. With Chennai is going to be a closed city, or 50 lockdown is not going to be seen by Chennai tomorrow. We have to be very careful in Chennai. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity and Office Bearers.